Now let's get information. Those of you who are waiting for Matt Lauer to be officially single, well, he is. Looks like the divorce is final between he and now his ex-wife, Annette. Looks like she walked away with $20 million in assets, according to TMZ.com. It is unclear exactly how they're splitting up their properties. They have a ton of New York State and New Zealand properties. New York Post reported Annette's getting their house farm in the Hamptons. The couple did split up in 2017 after Matt was fired from the Today Show over a slew of sexual harassment allegations at NBC. It appears Matt and Annette and their lawyers hashed out the division of their assets in private before filing the paperwork in court. Rihanna has been accused of cultural appropriation. The singer and fashion icon is the latest victim of the cultural appropriation versus appreciation argument. The Fenty beauty mogul recently posed for the August cover of Chinese Harper's Bazaar dressed in a geisha garb. A couture geisha garb. Social media immediately exploded, accusing Riri of ripping off traditional Chinese culture for attention, praise instead of the genuine tribute and interest. And this actually happened with Kim Kardashian West when she thought it was okay to, name her intimate apparel brand the kimono, knowing that that's not the case. Kim withdrew that name because folks were saying that she was not appreciating the Japanese tradition for that garb, and so she's dropped that claim and now she's starting from scratch. Russell Simmons is in hot water again, this time with former employees. It looks as though he's clearing out everything at the All Def Digital empire. Russell Simmons founded All Def Digital, and according to the Jasmine brand, he may have come as a shock to the public, but a number of now former employees have spoken out what the work culture was really like, saying they suffered bad press after Simmons faced sexual assault allegations last year. He stepped down from the company after launching it in 2013. The YouTube network was on track to create original programs, platforms, Facebook, and HBO, raising $18 million thanks to investors. So rumors were swirling that the company was shutting down entirely after firing almost all of its staff last week. The CEO says, "We are reorganizing the company in advance of a strategic deal." Several other former employees said that they were told the company couldn't stay in business after being the target of several scandals, making it a risk for investors and other businesses in the music industry. The content was dope. The leadership was piss poor, one of them being quoted as saying. Every bad stereotype that you hear about what this industry could be thrived in that environment. It was a S show, fill in the blanks, from day one. It was everything you were warned about. The Russell era was very Jersey. It was just a Jersey that they wore for the show. We were down to just two women at one point because literally every other person with a hot pocket walked out of the building. The staff went from 60 to 15. At one point, they weren't certain if they would even get paid. Money was always an unsure thing for them, always asking about their checks. Ooh, that's not good. Not Russell Simmons. Anyway, I'm just going to keep moving. So you heard the news. ASAP Rocky is now in a Swedish prison. So you heard about the story. You need to just log on to the internet. You'll see it there. Well, now there is a free ASAP petition going on. Folks want him out of jail because he's, you know, not being treated fairly. That's how some folks are. He's being met with an overwhelming amount of support from fans, followers, and even fellow celebrities regarding his recent arrest. Footage was captured of Pretty Flacco and company being allegedly followed and harassed by Swedish men. It incited a brawl in which the rapper friends and a bodyguard were arrested. ASAP was the one that got arrested. ASAP Ferg announced that he was being unjustly held in a Swedish prison. T.I., Tyler, the creator, Schoolboy Q, vowed to boycott Sweden due to ASAP's arrest. A petition started by the rapper's camp. Details that an appeal was filed earlier this week for his release. It was denied, keeping him detained for the next 2 weeks. Jay-Z is adding weed connoisseur to his resume. He's getting into the weed business and partnering with a cannabis company in California, taking on another venture and joining the marijuana business. He's been named the chief brand strategist for Caliva, a privately owned cannabis company in San Jose, California, already signing on to a multi-year partnership. He explained why he contacted the company, says, I want to do correctly and at the highest level. He says, anything I do, I want to do correctly and at the highest level with all the potential in the cannabis industry. So he wants to do something for this and even still standing for those who were arrested for, you know, weed possession and currently serving time for weed possession. Like, if this is what we're doing and we're monetizing off of this thing, you know, it's being legalized now. So he also wants to help set up with job training for former inmates and push strategies that will improve the representation of the previously incarcerated in the weed industry. So that's a good move, I guess. Congratulations, Jay-Z.